We want to solve the given log equations. Normally when solving a log equation with more than one log, we combine the logs into a single log and then write the equation as an exponential equation to solve for x. But for these two equations, we can actually save ourselves some work by taking a slightly different approach. Looking at our first equation, we will go ahead and combine the two common logs on the left side of the equation. And since we have a sum here, that means we can combine these two logs by multiplying the number parts of the two logs, or the quantity x minus 2 and the quantity x plus 3. So the common log of the quantity x minus 2 plus the common log of the quantity x plus 3 is equal to the common log of the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity x plus 3. This is still equal to the common log of 6. Now in this form, notice how we have a common log on the left, a common log on the right, and they're equal to each other. So if these two logs are equal to each other, then the number parts of the logs must also be equal to each other, which means the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity x plus 3 must equal 6. So for this equation, there's no reason to subtract log 6 on both sides, combine the logs again, and then write an exponential equation. While it would work, this is actually much faster. So again, the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity x plus 3 must equal 6. Now we're going to clear the parentheses and solve for x. So we'll have four products here, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we'll have x squared plus 3x minus 2x minus 6 equals 6. We do have a quadratic equation, so now we'll combine the like terms here and also subtract 6 on both sides. So we'll have x squared, this will be plus x minus 6 equals 6. We'll subtract 6 on both sides of the equation. This would be 0 on the right. So we have x squared plus x minus 12 equals 0. Looks like this will factor. The factors of x squared are x and x. Now we want the factors of negative 12 that add to positive 1. That would be positive 4 and negative 3. So we have the quantity x plus 4 and the quantity x minus 3. Now the solutions to this will be the factors of x that make each factor equal to 0. So here x equals negative 4 or x equals positive 3. But it's important when solving a log equation that we check our solutions. Notice when x is negative 4, we would have the log of negative 4 minus 2 with a log of negative 6. And that's not possible since the number part of a logarithm is always greater than 0. Therefore, x equals negative 4 is not a solution to this equation. Notice when x is 3, we have the log of 1 plus the log of 6 equals log 6, which would be true. So our solution is only x equals 3. Looking at our second equation, we're going to take the same strategy. We're going to combine the two logs on the left side of the equation. Notice how they're both natural logs. And again, we have a sum. So we can combine these two logs by multiplying the number parts of the two logs, or x plus 5 and x. So natural log of the quantity x plus 5 plus natural log x is equal to the natural log of the quantity x plus 5 times x, or x times the quantity x plus 5, equals natural log 12x. And again, once we have this, since we have two natural logs equal to each other, the number parts of their logarithms must be equal. So x times the quantity x plus 5 must equal 12x. Now we'll solve this for x, so we'll clear the parentheses. We'd have x squared plus 5x equals 12x. So we'll go and subtract 12x on both sides of the equation. Notice on the right side we'd have 0. Left side we have x squared. And then 5x minus 12x is negative 7x, so we have minus 7x. And then we'll factor out the common factor of x, so we have x times the quantity x minus 7 equals 0. So based upon this equation, x equals 0, or x equals 7. But again, let's go ahead and check these solutions. Notice here we'd have natural log 0, which does not exist because the number part of this log is always going to be greater than 0. Therefore, x equals 0 cannot be a solution. Notice when x is 7, all the number parts of the logs would be positive. Therefore, our solution is x equals 7. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.